10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, Lee Mack, Vic Reeves, Sarah Pascoe, Alex Horn and the Horn Section, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, in Papua New Guinea, the word for 10 is two hands? It's actually a very traditional society. Papua New Guinea goes out to work every morning, while Mama New Guinea stays home to look after the kids. There are 100 native speakers of Manx, the language spoken in the Isle of Man. So Manx is a language and not, as I thought, a type of elasticated control pant for dads. And numeracy and literacy skills in the UK have declined since 2003. But don't worry, we're still world leaders in starting wars and closing libraries. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Sean Locke's bubbly outlook and friendly personality mean he's the life and soul of any fight in a Wetherspoons car park. Sean Locke is one of the finest comedians in the country, a hilarious stand-up and a brilliant all-round guy. And joining Sean tonight is Vic Reeves. Yes, Vic Reeves. He's crazier than the paving outside a pensioner's bungalow. He's more wacky than a hungry Jeremy Clarkson. And he's nuttier than Mrs. Brown's knickers. Up against them this evening, it's our special guest team captain, Lee Mack. Lee Mack is from Blackburn in Lancashire, but now lives in London because, well, you would, wouldn't you?
Not, but it'll go with the joke. I'm from Southport, but carry on. Still works.
Lee Mack is from Southport, but now lives in London. Because, well, you would, wouldn't you?
Doesn't work, because no one knows where Southport is. Yeah, you're from Southport, you idiot. I mean, forget it.
Lee used to work in a bingo hall, but don't worry, you won't have to deal with confused pensioners struggling with the numbers tonight, because you're not on Sean's team. And Lee's teammate, Sarah Pascoe. Sarah is a vegan, and if you want to know what that is, it's basically a non-meat eater who doesn't find being a vegetarian quite sanctimonious enough.
Is there something more strict than vegan?
Yeah, fruitarians?
No way.
Yeah?
I thought just that was the new name for opal fruits.
And there's people, I think, who only eat raw vegan food.
Cardboardarians.
Can you have eggs?
No, but why is it so...
Is that your chat-up line, Jimmy? You can go take a day off here.
Yeah. I'm not saying Sarah's going to struggle at Countdown tonight, but she has somehow managed to misspell Sarah.
Just, OK, my parents spelt my name. I had nothing to do with it, did I? I was being born. I would have put an H on the end if I could go back and be listened to.
You could just add the H now, couldn't you?
Could I?
It's written there.
Where is it?
It's on the front of there.
Yeah, Rachel's got some letters.
Have you got, could you find us a H in the consonants?
It might be a bit bigger, but there'll be one in here somewhere.
You want a H?
Yeah.
All right. We can actually make you an... Oh, hang on.
Oh, my God. Oh.
You've got to be careful doing that, because you get helicopters landing everywhere.
Does that look OK?
Yeah.
Can I adjust that? I'm a bit anal with that. I've got to see the A as well.
OK, there we go.
I love the idea that someone's just tuning in now going, my right eye is knackered.
OK, Lee, you've been a guest captain on the show before, but you've never won. Is that going to change tonight?
Oh, definitely, yes. I've done a lot of work since I was last on the show. I plan to join all the list of great British captains. I'm, of course, talking about Sensible, Caveman, Birdseye, Corelli's Mandolin.
How are you going to motivate your teammate, Sarah?
I told her before we came on the show, you know, I gave her the motivating words, didn't I, of the sooner, you know, we get this done, the sooner we can go home.
OK, Sarah, what are you going to bring to the team?
Well, I'm going to bring compassion, hope, integrity, poor eyesight, and I think I might be immortal. So if the game goes on for ages, I'll still be here winning for us.
You, sorry, you think you might be immortal?
I've never died. And I can't imagine being dead. I just can't imagine
not being here. You're too young.
Because, Alex, you're working on something at the moment, aren't you?
Well, I'm trying to get into the Guinness Book of Records as the oldest man in the world, which is taking up a lot of my time, but I'm currently... I'm a new personal best, 36. When I was born, I was the worst person in the world at being the oldest man in the world. So I've gone up about 3 billion places.
OK. Sean, what were your hobbies as a kid?
I used to love playing computer games, you know, Call of Duty.
Call of Duty, when you were a kid, was conscription.
No, I used to collect stuff. I used to collect butterflies. I spent hours admiring the delicate structure of their wings and the beautiful colours. Then I used to roll them into a ball and put them in my pocket. It turned out my collection was worthless. And death rattles. I used to practice death rattles.
Could you give us an example of a death rattle?
That's one. This is my own personal favourite.
You do let out a big, it's your last breath, isn't it? So I think I might die with one of those things you get at kids' parties in my mouth.
Oh, yeah.
So the very last thing I do is go... give one a bit of lift, isn't it?
My granddad's last words as we all gathered around him were very, very poignant. His very last words were, as he lay there, he just went, knock, knock.
that would have been a lot funnier if you'd have saved it for the coffin.
No, I was annoyed because he was a funny bloke. I bet it was a good one.
If this would have been the real countdown and we'd been talking about this, you'd have had to say if you're affected by any of these issues.
Vic, last time you were on the show, you made up quite a lot of words.
That's the idea, isn't it?
To a point, but ideally you're meant to sort of make them up from words in the dictionary.
Yeah.
We'll try and stick with dictionary
words. Well, yeah, all right then.
Okay, Lee, have you got a mascot?
I have got a mascot, Jimmy. Yes,
excellent.
I have got
news.
A mascot. At first I was thinking of using you, because I recently watched all your DVDs and I thought, you are the luckiest man I know. I brought with me my lucky wishbone. It's my little lucky wishbone. And a funny story behind this, actually. This is the wishbone that my nan choked on and I inherited her house. Look at it. So, pop that there. And think of nan.
Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I bought some like lucky kind of witchcrafty things. So this is a magic eight ball. If you ask it a question, it tells you the answer. Am I going to be the best today? Yes, definitely. It does say that, but now it's hidden. And these are fortune cookies, so it gives you advice. Confession is good for the soul. I once killed a man.
Stop it. Sean, have you got a mascot?
No, Jimmy, I haven't got a mascot. But Channel 4, basically... They've been complaining to me, they've been moaning to me that I don't have a digital profile, I'm not on Twitter, I'm not on Facebook, I don't have a website, I haven't got an email address. In fact, the only way you can find any record of me, I did get a high score on a pinball machine once. they said, well, we'd like you to do some tweeting. We'll set up a Twitter account and it for you. And you can live tweet while it's being recorded. So I have a few tweets through. I've had this one. This is from Jamie. And he says, hi, Sean, just wanted to say love the show. Good luck tonight against Lee and Sarah. See, I don't know what you do when someone tweets you. What do you...
Well, you can either retweet that to your followers or you could retweet it with a comment.
All right. I was going to say, leave me alone. Oh, there's a good one. This is from Hillary in Ashby de la Zouch. Sean, I hate you. I hope you lose as usual. You thicko. That's more like it. I'll read some more out later as they come through.
Sure. Vic, do you have a mascot?
Yes, here. Yeah. It's a fossilised... No, it's a mummified cod. Which, I believe, caused the death by choking of Queen Chit-chot.
What was she the queen of?
Egypt. Quite, it's quite a cheeky little fella, isn't he?
Yeah. Yeah.
So there's my mascot. Thank you and good night.
Over in Dictionary Corner, we've got Alex Horn in the horn section. Now, obviously, it's great to have you here. Could you introduce the horn section?
Well, we could sing a little song if you want, just to say, you know, hello, if you want.
That'd be fabulous.
Yeah, OK.
Ready? One, two.
Here we go. You know your love lifted me higher than I've ever been lifted before. To keep it up, quench my desire, and I'll be at your side forevermore. Your love, keep on lifting.
Hiya! Hiya!
And...
Hello.
There we go.
And with Alex Horn in the horn section, of course, it's Susie Dent! Susie spent her whole life studying the art of lexicography, and now, with her regular appearances on Countdown, she's been given the opportunity to share her boring work with the rest of the country. Susie, what's the weirdest rumour you've heard about yourself on this show?
On one of the more popular fact sites, which aren't always facts, they said I'd been in prison in Cambodia for a while, and I was married to a paperclip millionaire. But, you know, you can never trust those sites, because they say you're a comedian. Trying to get my own back.
And in charge of the numbers, Rachel Riley. Rachel is a role model for any intelligent, ambitious young woman who wants to have a career standing next to a row of jumbled-up letters. Rachel, if you had to be stranded on a desert island with either me, Susie, Lee or Sean, who would you go with?
Well, Susie would be quite good. She's quite strong. She's good at arm wrestling. But I think I'd go for someone taller that could kind of reach the coconut. So maybe one of the guys. I don't know Lee well enough. I think Sean...
You'd have to know me well to know how tall I am.
You want someone tall enough to reach the
coconuts? Reach the coconuts, I think.
Not tiny Jimmy. Little Jimmy Carr.
You can't reach the coconuts.
John can. John can. Oh, Jimmy, do you want me to get you a coconut? Oh, you know, because you didn't come, because Rachel didn't invite you.
Invited and she doesn't even know me very well.
I think Sean will be the first one to turn to cannibalism. So
Sean wouldn't even wait for you to be shipwrecked for that.
So yeah, I'd pick you, Jimmy. I think you'd probably be the first one to be able to call a helicopter. And chances are if we've gone to a desert island, we might be there for tax purposes. It might be somewhere nice.
It's a good point well made. OK, tonight the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Picnic Hamper. Go that way. Fabio, Fabio, you dropped your Scotch egg. Literally, that is his only job. OK, that's Countdown, everyone. Time for the first game. Lee and Sarah, you get the first pick of the letters.
OK.
Please.
Can I have a vowel, please?
Thank you, Sarah. Start with E.
And do you want another go? Shall I carry on?
Please.
Consonant, please.
Can I have a go, I was going to say?
T. Oh.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Yeah. S.
Oh, please.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
F.
Vowel, please.
O.
Vowel, please.
A.
Thought so. Consonant.
P.
And you say the last one, because I've got to rearrange my letters that
oh,
I've
no,
got so
I
far.
Too. Okay. We've got longer if we keep...
Consonant. OK, and your time starts now. Sean, how many?
Five.
Five. OK, Vic?
Six.
Ooh. Lee?
Eight.
OK, Sarah?
Six, but I think it's wrong.
OK, yeah. So let's start with your five, Sean.
Foist.
Like a New York cop would say first. Didn't it? Vic, your six?
Piston.
Good word. Very good.
Sarah, your six?
OK, so I've written stipend, which is like a stipend, but without the end, so it's not finished. It's still going.
Susie, stipend?
No stipend without
yet.
The D.
Lee, you're eight.
Just letting you know about a little thing I did on holiday. I went to Utopia the other week, and you know the country, Utopia. And people often say to me, they say, you know, Utopia was nice, but what are the people from Utopia called?
Idiots.
Utopians. So that's E-T-O-P-I-A-N-S.
Susie, is that made-up word in the dictionary?
Nearest you get is Ethiopian.
OK, so 6 points to Sean and Vic.
Yes.
Susie, Alex, could they have done any better?
If they'd got longer words...
they would have done better.
Yeah, exactly. Sevens or eights. Would have been more. Nine would have been more.
Nine would have been terrific.
More than six.
We had sapient panties. Both those are sevens.
Panties.
Panties.
Panties,
oh,
yeah. Panties off. So at the end of that, Sean and Vic are in the lead with six. On to our first numbers round. Sean and Vic, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, two good. From the top, please, and everywhere else.
And four little. Thank you, Sean. And for the first numbers today, they are nine.
Ooh.
Oh, another nine.
Ooh.
Five, one, and the big one's 125. And the target, 527.
Ooh. Okay, your time starts now. OK, so the target was 527. Did you get it, Sean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Vic, did you get it?
Nah.
Lee, did you get it?
I got it.
Sarah, did you get it?
No. No. Well, I've got 500 by timesing 100 times 5, and what? Then I added 25 to that, which is 1 times 25, and then I just looked at that for ages, hoping that the line...
You could just use the 25.
You could, but then there's more numbers left to befuddle you. And then I just literally stared at two nines, going, please become two.
What's 9 divided by...?
9? Nothing.
Oh, no.
Yes, I think
well,
so.
But if 9 divided by 9 was 1...
Is it? Yeah. Then... Oh! Oh! Thanks, guys. I've got it now. Yes!
Lee, did you get it, Lee?
I did it exactly the same way, but just a bit quicker.
Take us through it, Lee. How did you do it?
I took the 100, and then I timed it by the 5.
500.
And then I added the 25.
Yep.
Then I added the 1.
Yep.
And I thought, right, I'm going to need another 1 here. And I've only got a 9 and a 9. I thought, well, I can't divide them because that equals nothing. But then I remembered the last minute it was 1. So I created a 1 that way. But then I was still thinking, but what next? And then I thought, I wonder if I was to add those numbers up. I think that makes 527.
It does indeed. 527.
Yeah.
Sean, did you do it the same way?
Yes, exactly the same.
OK, so Sean and Vic have 16, Lee and Sarah have 10.
Come on!
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Alex, what have you got for us?
Sorry, I'm very hungry, so I thought we'd do some cooking. That's right.
Yeah, sure.
We're going to do cooking with music against the clock, because it's countdown. So we've got a microwave, so we're going to cook... I'm going to cook a dish for Susie. You can do this at home if you want. This is I'll instruct you how to do it. It involves an egg, and we end up with an egg dish. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go. This is how to cook an egg dish. Good luck. 1, 2, 3, and... Pick up an egg and pick up a cup. Hit it 3 times so the egg opens up. Pour out the contents and dispose of the shell into a bin. Here you go, mate. Now pick up a fork. That's right. Stir it all up. Give it a good old whisk. Make the most of the cup. The yolk and the albumen should now look like a sort of egg. Now go to the microwave and open the door. Put in the cup, then shut the door. Type in 1 minute, and when I say now, you can press start. Here we go. Now. Pick up a knife, batter the bread. Creamy and thick, a real generous bread. Pick up the ketchup and dollop it onto one slice. You're going to be eating this in a minute. Here we go. Pick up the knife, then pick up the bread. And then change your mind, put down the bread. Check on the microwave. Should see there's 30 seconds left. We're halfway to egg heaven. Now pick up your cup, because you now want a drink. You can't find the cup. Where is the cup? The cup's in the microwave, and that's where the egg is heating up. I think it's going pretty well. You don't need a drink, you just need an egg. So check on the clock. Oh, there's 10 seconds left. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. And then we just get out the delicious, delicious egg dish here. And this really is a treat for you, Susie. It's like an egg ball. Just put that there. Anyone could do this. And then you just gobble it up, really, once you've cooked it. So there we go, Susie.
I've just become a fruitarian.
Have you? Very interesting.
I'd buy that song.
I really like that.
It's one of the best songs I've heard for a long time.
I didn't know it was a song.
I genuinely despise the song, but I love the recipe.
It is edible. I mean, in that you can put it in your mouth, but, I mean, we don't know what the repercussions are going to be.
We'll find out.
Another one of Jimmy's chat-up lines.
Dawn and the Horn Section, everyone. Here is your teaser. The words are sour tits. The clue is always getting in the way. That's sour tits, always getting in the way. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were sour tits. The clue was always getting in the way. It was, of course, tourists. So, Sean and Vic are in lead with 16 points. Time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Lee. So, Sean, your turn to choose.
Yes, can I have a vowel, please, Rachel?
E.
Another vowel, please.
O.
Another vowel, please.
E.
And another vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
Z.
Consonant, please.
R.
Consonant, please.
G.
Consonant, please.
L.
Consonant, please.
And the last one, R.
OK, and your time starts now. What did you get, Sean? How many?
Six.
Lee?
Eight.
I hope someone remembers this country.
OK, Sean, let's hear your six.
Regale.
Ooh!
Very nice.
Yeah. You've changed.
OK, Lee, your eight.
Reglazer.
Yeah, right, it's a clap.
Reglaze is in, but not reglazer.
Well, hang on, who's doing the work? If you can reglaze, somebody has to have that profession.
Glazier reglazes.
Reglazer. Well, what's a glazer? Someone who glazes.
Yeah.
So a reglazer, someone who, if you break your glaze,
you just get the same glazer back. You wouldn't get a, glazer. You do the job.
Glaze once, can't you? You
no. I was born in a very rough part of the country. There were so many broken windows, it became a profession. Reglazing.
While you've been arguing about this, Susie wrote the R on the end of it in the dictionary, so it's now officially in.
I don't like to be like this, but I mean, countdown rules are very important. It's right in my nature to say I would love it to be fine and it would be great, but. You know, tough on the rules.
But if rules are unfair, then they should be changed. And I feel like the world should reward people who tried really hard, and that's Lee.
I feel both pleased and patronised at the same time.
I'll tell you what, Lee. 6 points to Sean. Should they have done any better?
There's quite a scary word, areole.
Oh, yeah. Was that though, was it?
Why is that scary?
It's scary because it comes up quite a lot on Countdown and I almost always do these involuntary hand gestures.
Yeah. OK, so at the end of all that, Sean and Vic have 22, Lee and Sarah have 10. Right, now it's time for Sarah and Vic to go head-to-head. Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
Great. Can I have two big ones and the rest small ones?
Thank you, Sarah. Two large, four little. And this time the little ones are 9, 2, 9, 10. And the big ones, 25 and 100. And the target, 660.
So, Alex, you've got the band here. Why don't you do the countdown music for this one?
Yeah, we could do. I mean, I was hoping to wash down the egg with one of these. So can we do it in sort of a German-style countdown clock?
And you're going to down that in 30 seconds?
I'm going to try.
OK, your time starts now. like a tiny drop.
Is there a bit?
I think one is just, it's just on the...
Just on the lapel.
It's fine.
I'm very pleased with myself.
So the number was 660. Sarah. Vic, did you get it?
No.
Sarah, did you get it?
No. But in my defence, this one's really hard. And if you'd done the last one again, I would have got it this time.
We get a point for the nearest one, too.
Well, right, so yeah. How close did you get, Vic?
Well, I got three, and I also got 2,500.
Well, what did you get?
I got 225.
Let's find out if it could be done. Rachel, could it be done?
Yep, it could have been done. You could have said 100 minus 25 minus 9 is 66, and times it by 10.
Oh.
Can I just explain how I got to my three?
Yeah, how did you get the three, yeah?
The ten minus the nine equals one, and one times two equals two, and you just add them together.
But hang on, you've used the one twice. The scores at the moment, Sean and Vic are on 22, Lee and Sarah are on 10. And here is your teaser. The words are pube rugs. The clue is very resistant. That's pube rugs, very resistant. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were pube rugs. The clue was very resistant. It was, of course, superbug. Sean, have you had any more tweets in your live tweeting?
I'm glad you asked me, Jimmy, because, yes, I have. I've actually just got my first death threat.
I'm sure it's not from the real Hugh Edwards. This is a nice one. This is from Jerry in Basildon. Hi, Sean. Can you think of a new biscuit? That's somebody using the medium in, you know, in a creative, positive way. And a hybrid of a hobnob and a jammy dodger. I haven't decided on the name yet. It's either a hob dodger or a jammy knob.
OK, on with the game. Lee and Sarah, your turn to choose the letters.
Ooh, great. OK.
Would you like to choose them, Sarah?
I would like to choose two of them. And a vowel, please.
T and U.
Right. Sarah, relax. I'm going to take it from here.
Great.
Can I have three consonants, please, Rachel?
Ooh.
T and L.
And we'll have a vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
U.
A consonant.
Another T.
We'll have a vowel, please.
O.
OK, your time starts now. Lee, how many did you get?
Five.
Ooh. Sarah?
Six.
Sean?
I've only got four.
Ha! Idiot!
Vic?
Six.
Let's hear your four, Sean.
Pout.
OK. Lee, your five?
Pluto.
Susie, can you have Pluto?
Not with a small P.
Who's the thicko now?
What's your six, Vic?
Puttle. P-U-T-T-L-E. It's a very small puddle.
I mean, if it's not in there, it should be. It's a great word.
Not in. I looked up puddle because I thought you were going to come up
with
that.
That's my word.
Neither of them are in.
Change that quick.
So, Sarah, what was your word?
Now, my word is...
Well, you're really good at thinking under pressure.
Pot.
So, 4 points for Sean's team. OK, Alex, Susie, could they have done any better?
I've got
Puzzle, Teapot, Pulitzer and Opulent, none of which can't do any of them. and the quite a frightening word, output.
You could have put out. I put out someone's window recently and guess what? Guess who I phoned?
I wonder.
The reglazer.
It's in the dictionary.
Just saying.
OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner once again. Alex, what have you got for us this time?
Well, I thought it'd be nice to involve this guy. Will, the bassist, who... he's kind of the least... not respected, but least appreciated member of the band. Imagine if you go to the zoo and you get, like, the lions and the penguins, and he's more like just a pigeon, he's flown in. You wouldn't miss him. If he wasn't there, you wouldn't know he was there. So I thought we'd let him play a few notes by himself, because he can do it really well. Do a C for Jimmy. Do a C. Huh? Ooh. Pretty good. My favourite one of his notes is the A, which is rather special. Do an A. Wow, isn't it? Compare that to the B. I've never liked the B. Do a B. Do it again. And then the A. Do the A. See what I mean? The G, I have no idea. I have no emotions about the G. Do the G. Does nothing for me. Whereas the E, I'm very happy. Do an E. And that spells cabbage. It's nice to know what cabbage sounds like. We know what it tastes like. This is what it sounds like. Play cabbage.
C A B B A G E.
It's a cabbage song.
C A B B A G E.
It's a cabbage song.
C-A-B-B-A-G-E.
Where are we eating the cabbage? In the cafe. We're eating the cabbage in the cafe. Play cafe. C A F E. That's cafe. C. And now I'm thirsty. Give me a coffee. Decaf. D-E-C-A-F, that's decaf. I'm still hungry though, give me some beef. Beef. B-E-E-F, that's beef. Nice, isn't it? One more. And then you can do egg. Egg, can you do egg? E-G-G, that's egg. One more egg, and then finally, last one, can you do beetroot? Beetroot. B-E-E-troot. You can't do them all, but it's nice, isn't it? It's really the basics.
Alex Horn and the Horn Section, everyone.
You're right, you know, I wouldn't miss him.
The scores at the moment, Sean and Vic have 26, Lee and Sarah have 10. And here's your final teaser. The words are anal mist, the clue is brings me luck. That's anal mist, brings me luck. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were anal mist. The clue was brings me luck. It was, of course, talisman. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Vic, your turn to choose.
Vic?
Make yourself
how
useful.
Many is there?
Nine.
Yeah, we'll have nine, then.
You choose.
All right, three consonants.
R, N and G.
Three vowels.
I. E and I.
A consonant.
N.
A vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
And a last one, T.
Thank you.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Sean, how many?
Seven.
Vic?
Seven.
Lee?
Nine.
Ooh. Oh, very cool, nine. Sarah?
I'm going to go seven.
Sarah, what's your seven?
Ringier. What
is that?
Ringier. Something that's more ringier. Ringier.
Ah, OK. Susie, is ringier...
I'll tell you how I'm spelling it. R-I-N-G-I-E-R. Ringier.
You'd need two R's.
Uh-oh.
But it's not in. I don't know if that helps or not.
So double wrong. That's what we're saying. Vic, you're seven?
Can I have a go at two? There's one that I'm not convinced about, but I know I've got one for sure.
We would let you, but Sean's really strict on the rules.
Yeah, I'm very strict.
I've got renting.
Renting?
Renting, but I'd like nut ring.
So renting you're going for, but nut ring. Is nut ring in there by any chance?
It's not.
Is it not there? I'm surprised.
OK, Sean, you're seven.
Turning. Turn, as in to turn. when you need to change the direction of a car, turning it.
I mean, turning, we've already had a brilliant explanation sort of delivered as if we're deaf pensioners.
It's in turning.
Let's go to the nine. Lee, your nine letter word.
Reuniting.
Yay!
Well, amazingly, that's 18 points to Lee. I imagine Sean is fine with that, because that is part of the rules.
Yeah. It's just a game.
Okay. It's an incredible reversal of fortune.
Yes. It's fantastic. It's what makes this game so addictive.
OK. So, Susie, Alex, could they have done any better?
How? Guess nine!
There's a ten, actually.
Actually, that word cropped up recently, and this is why... Because my... I don't know if I mentioned, but my window smash recently. And when the reglazer came round, I said, what exactly are you doing? He says, I'm reuniting the window with the window frame. I said, you are not just clever, you are one of the cleverest reglazers I've ever met.
And he was from Etopia.
He's best Etopian reglazer.
Now, I'm adding a little story with all the words I've used so far. And they all fucked off to Pluto. Get on with the show.
Okay, so Sean and Beck have 26 points. Lee and Sarah are now in the lead with 28. So fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
Oh, sorry, I've started. I was going to go for Downton.
And your time starts now. Lee.
Well, I don't know if this is right, it might be wrong. So what I'm going to go for is... I know it! It is...
Start the clock again!
Can I go again?
Yeah.
It's me!
Can we not stop the clock?
Bibs!
Stop the clock! Stop the frigging clock!
Is it Birmingham?
Renumbering.
Numbering.
Renumbering.
No, it's numbering.
Numbering. That's what I meant. Numbering.
Sorry. As a stickler for the rules.
No. It's numbering and I'm having it. It doesn't matter, we've won anyway. It doesn't matter because they can't capture us. Whatever, don't care. Who needs a hammer?
Are we giving them the 10?
Are we giving them the 10? Says the referee finger that lives in his ear.
If you were in charge of the
10. Oh, you little finger.
Come on, give me a straight answer. You'll go up the nose.
We don't need it. We're 2 points ahead. But take your 10 and stick it with the sun don't shine. Give me the hamper and let's just get the news on.
Let's have a look and see if that was right. It was the right answer, but too late.
Too late?
Too late.
Our games didn't work.
Sorry, the final scores are Children Vic have 26, but at the last minute they did it. Lee and Sarah have 28. Marvel, they're the winners. Congratulations, Lee and Sarah. You're now the proud owners of this countdown. To all our families, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you for watching at home, that's it from us. Good night.
Next week, Adam, Josh and Alex are back, along with the totally tall Stephen Merchant in a new series of The Last Leg. That's live next Friday at 10. Well, coming up, years of training, and it's all down to this for one last summer in the north. Sarah Millican, it's Homebird Live. That's next.